Hello friends, in my this video I am going to discuss one very important array related program in MATLAB and Java. Okay, so this program also termed as number of numbers. Okay, so what is that? Given an array A of n elements, that n may be anything given by the user, your task is to write such program which returns an integer denoting the total number of times digit k appears in the whole array, and this k is also going to be user input. Suppose, for example, suppose this array is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. These are the elements in the array A. Now suppose user has given input k equal to 1. Now see how many times 1 is present in this particular array. In the 11, 2 times in the 12, 1 times in the 13, 1 times in the 14, 1 times in the 15, 1 times. So total 6 times this k equal to 1, that is the 1 value is present in this particular array. So output should be printed as 6. So this is the program. Obviously, it is quite clear that in this case also we have to use the digit extraction concept from a number, which I already discussed several times in my previous videos. If you want the detailed explanation, please go through the link given in the description, okay? Because that is the base for this particular program. So what we will do, we will take each and every numbers corresponding to the particular array, and on that particular number we will use digit extraction concept, and after extracting each digit we will check whether that is equal to the k value or not. If that particular digit is equal to k value, then we will increment one counter, else we will not increment that, and then the end of the execution in that particular counter, the total number of digits which is equal to k in that particular array will be stored. Okay, so let us directly go to the program. See, very simple, CLC, then take the input array, then k equal to input, enter the numbers, then c equal to 0. Here we have defined the counter as 0. Then for I equal to 1 colon length of x, so I will traverse the loop from starting to the end, m equal to x of I. So each number from the array will take and is stored in m variable. Then see, this part is no doubt, this part is nothing but digit extraction from a number in MATLAB, whatever I have discussed. That is, while m greater than 0, b equal to remainder m comma 10. If b equal to k, this part is just the new part. For this particular program, we will check whether each extracted digit is equal to that k which we want to search in that array. If it is equal, then increment the counter. No need to write else part, because else if it is not satisfying, then no need to perform anything. M equal to m minus b by 10, end the while loop and the external for loop. So at the end of the execution of the whole program in the c variable, total number of occurrence of that particular integer will be stored in C. Okay, let us check. Suppose 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, and enter the number. Suppose let me give 11, enter. Now write C. See, 6 times it is repeated, as we have shown already earlier in our discussion also. So let us check for other 11, 12, 13. Let me give this. Enter the number 0. See, now you write C, that's C, C equal to 0, because 0 is not at all repeated. Now suppose enter the array 11, 22, 12, 24. Okay, and 2 I want to search. See, in 22 2 times, in 12 1 time. So number of occurrence is 3. Let us check. See, sorry, in 22 2 times, in 12 1 times, and in 24 also 1 time. So total number of occurrence is 4. Okay, so our code is perfectly working. Now this code you can implement in Java also. The program is same, only see how you can implement. First, we have taken input from the users so that you can use either scanner class or buffer reader class in Java. But as we are dealing with inputs which are basically integers, so you can use scanner class, because in buffer reader you have to write more. But the disadvantage of scanner class is that if you are working with string related programs, then always try to use buffer reader, because I personally have faced some problems in using this scanner class also. in string related programs. Okay, so better to use for string related programs, better to use buffer reader. So import the scanner class from the utility package in Java, then class buk I have given random class name. You can give your own class name, okay, no issue in that. The public static void main string args scanner obj new scanner system dot in, this is to create object in the scanner class. Then system dot out dot println, enter the array length. Okay, then int a equal to obj.nextint. Then we are taking input array inputs, that is int a equal to new int l for int I equal to 0, I less than l, I plus plus. System.out.println, enter the ith element, a of I equal to obj.nextint. Okay, so now System.out.println, enter the number you want to search. Okay, then that is stored in k variable, like whatever we have used in MATLAB. Then int m equal to 0, int b equal to 0, int c equal to 0. C, m, b and c we are using in MATLAB. We have not defined earlier what is its data type or what is its initial value, but if you are working with Java, you must have to do this initializations, right? Then like same algorithm for I equal to 1 colon length of x in MATLAB, in Java for int I equal to 0, I less than l, I plus plus. M equal to x of I in MATLAB, m equal to a of I in Java. Then while m greater than 0 in Java, similarly here, see, while m greater than 0 in MATLAB. B equal to remainder m comma 10 in MATLAB, here in Java directly use modulo symbol, so b equal to m mod 10. B equal to k, then c equal to c plus 1. And here for the next iteration, what we do, m equal to m minus b by 10 to get the quotient. Here you can directly quotient by using simply divide symbol, because m is integer, so always quotient will be stored while dividing. Okay, no remainder, so m equal to m by 10. Okay, this loop will keep on, and at the end of the execution we have to print c. So what I have done, System.out.println, so that I want to just give one space in between input and output, so that I have written this line. If you want, you can write. If you don't no need to write. And then System.out.println c, that is total number of occurrence of that particular number in that array, that is number of numbers, will be given as output. Okay, let us check whether our code is working or not. So go to command prompt, then cd java, then java c duk dot java, then java duk. Okay, enter the array length. Suppose let me give 4, then 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, enter the third element, enter the number you want to search. Suppose I want to search 1. So in 11, 2 times, in 12, 1 times, in 13, 1 times, in third element, that is 1 times. So total 5 times. Let us check. See, 1, enter, see 5, it is printing. Let us check for one more case. Suppose let me give here, enter the, let us check our test case itself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 elements are there. So array length 5, then 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. See, enter the number you want to search. 1, see, 6 it is printing. So code is perfectly working. Last test case, let us check. Java C, Java 11, 14, 78, 97. And enter the array length I have given 11, right? Okay. 45, 46, 13, 48, 79, 456, 71, and 43, or let me give 40. Okay, enter the number you want to search. Suppose let me give 0. See, 0 is there only in the 10th, that is last element of the array, that is 40, right? So only 1 times. See, let us check, enter. See, 1 it is printing. So this code is basically calculating number of numbers. Okay, so see, whatever a code I have implemented in MATLAB, same program, just little bit change in syntax I have implemented in Java. The base is nothing but what? Digit extraction from a number. That you should have a clear idea. If you have idea, well and good. If you don't know how to extract digits from a number, please go through the link given in the description. Okay, I'll post the two codes in a link. That link I'll provide in the description. If you want, you can check there. And if you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching.